niggas gon' be the ones with money and bitch. The pussies gon' be the niggas on the floor bleed. Now everybody keep their eyes on the prize, cause the ride get tricky. So you got some niggas on your side that say to your friends, but in real life, they're your enemies. Then you got some motherfuckers that say to your enemies, but in real life, they eyes is on your money. See, your enemies that say the truth, but in real life, those niggas are big snitches. It's a dirty game, y'all. Y'all got to be careful about who you fuck with and who you don't fuck with. Cause the shit get wild, y'all. Keep your mind on your riches, baby. Keep your mind on your riches. Tried to murder me from hood to the birds. Every one of you niggas heard of me shit. I'm legendary, nigga, scary and paralyzed. Nothing more out of size than the liar. Capped out, my mama told me when I was a thief. Such a bitch, motherfucker, why these devils set me free? I proceed to make them shiver when I deliver criminal lyrics from a worldwide mob figure. Thug niggas from everywhere, Mr. Machiavelli. Niggas is waiting for some thug shit, that's where they tell. So many rumors, but I'm infinite, immortal outlaw. Switching up on you ordinary bitches like a southpaw. And every breath I breathe until the moment I'm deceased of being at the moment falling as a D. I grip the ground and I start again. Eternally I live in sin until the moment that they let me breathe again.
The heart to the heart for the night. I was in every game.
Evening, everybody. Welcome to Chicago. I'm Jay Smalls. This is my new show. And welcome. I want to get into the top players at each position in the NBA. Shooting guard, point guard, small forward, power forward, and center. First, let's start with the centers because that's the most undervalued, most disrespected position that there is in the NBA today. And it wasn't like that 10, 15. The whole history of the NBA has been based around the center position. Now that is changing. All right. On my rankings, let's start from the top. F it, you know, I hate people who start from the bottom, and then I like to, you know, let's just get over with the BS. DeMarcus Cousins is the best center in the NBA currently. He's just bringing it back and forth as far as both ends on the court. He's taking that team in Sacramento on his back, as limited as they are at certain positions, at the small forward position, at the point guard position, power forward position. So he is a very limited front line, but he just is an amazing player. And put in the right situation, be it in Sacramento or somewhere else, he's going to flourish. Next, we got Joakim M.F.N. Noah from Chicago. Gentare, Joakim. This man has just separated himself. He's a center, but he is with a center with an asterisk because he should really be paying power forward, but he brings so much defensive tenacity and just really gets at it. And then in the offensive end, he's very on top of it as well and get everybody involved in his pass. He's the best big man passers, like almost simply, you know, like LeBron or Magic, but he's 6'11". Those guys aren't 6'11". It's just fun to watch, you know. Even with Derrick Rose going on, that makes it a gem to watch. After that, I would go. You have a toss up here between any three of these guys, to be honest with you. Roy Hibbert, DeAndre Jordan, and Dwight Howard. Not necessarily in those order. I'm not a big Dwight Howard fan. He's a regular season stud, and then he'll flake out in the playoffs. Until you start dominating in the playoffs, don't talk to me, Dwight, man. It's just, you know, I appreciate you took less money to go to Houston to try and build with something there, but if you guys aren't going to be committed to defense and playing as a team and gelling with a player like Omer Sheik, where you guys could dominate in the inside, it just speaks volumes to what your character is. I don't know you. I don't want to say that necessarily without ever meeting you, but it doesn't sit right with me. And then Roy Hibbert and DeAndre Johnson have just been SWAT blocking machines, block parties, man. Woo! And defensively, they've just been bringing it. Offensively, they bring it too. They you know, they're not going to get you 20 a night, but, you know, they'll get you 10 to 15 and be consistent. So, moving on to that, we got power forwards. Anthony Davis, hands down, number one. You're going to get a lot of arguments maybe with some people, but this kid is the future of the NBA, hands down. Hands down, this guy. Front court, I mean, 20 plus a game. He's getting 11 plus in the rebound category, 2 at least in the block category. This guy is just a man among men. Granted, now he's got Jarrell as a point guard, but hopefully, I wish they would have traded Eric Gordon and try and get them a small forward in there, because Tyreke Evans is just not working out as far as that. And they don't have a center to move Anthony Davis to his actual power forward position efficiently. So I'd like to see them get a big center to complement Anthony and then have a good shooting guard or small forward who has some length, because they could just be tenacious on the defensive end. Then next, you have Kevin Love. All you need is love, right, baby? That's what the Bulls need. All you need is love. He's tearing it up in Minnesota, as he always does, just putting up ridiculous number, 40-point nights, 26-point rebounds. It's just sickening. But they play in a bad team, and it just doesn't translate well. He needs to get on a winner, and he needs to get on a winner soon. Serge Ibaka has just been ridiculous. And, you know, I feel bad giving him the 3 spot, because Blake Griffin has just, I think, outplayed himself so well. I'm going to give Blake the 3 spot, then Ibaka the 4. But they're right there together. Defensively, Ibaka is just a beast. Offensively, he's come around and he's really hit his shot. And that 17 to 18 footer he's knocking down, and he's really getting his touch around the rim. And Blake is really expanding his shot, which makes him almost unguardable because of the way he can get at it at the rim. And his defensive game has really shown some commitment to it. So it's very nice to see that with that. And to round it out, LaMarcus Aldridge or Andre Drummond out of Detroit. As bad as Detroit has been, he's been very solid. And LaMarcus is, with Damian Lillard, has carried Portland so far this year. So we'll see what goes on in the playoffs. Best position, most coveted position, small forward. Of course, you got LeBron. Not much to say about that. He is the best player in the league right now. Kevin Durant, right certainly behind him. They're better in their different categories as far as scorer, defender, overall player. But LeBron's got the rings and Kevin does not. So that's the end of that story. Paul George is my number 3. He is sliding a little bit. He's hitting that wall, but I think he will hit it in the playoffs and go really at that Miami series and really solidify himself as a top 5, top 10 NBA, not top 10, but at least top 7 NBA player, top 5, top 7. So you got Carmelo. Don't call it Carmelo in New York. He's still a great player, ladies and gentlemen. Even at 29, 30 years old, don't think he's done. Jordan didn't win his first till he was 29, 30. So the people who think that's, you know, they're just ignorant. So, and then I got Kawhi Leonard. Not a lot of people would say that, but at my number 5. I just think he's a future at the small forward position, and growing up in the Spurs organization, he's just going to do nothing but great things for him. Small shooting guard position is one of the toughest to do judge here. So let's get into it just straight up. James Harden, number 1, hands down. He can handle it. Just his shot is outrageous. He's a top 6-7 player in the league. Oklahoma City just screwed themselves by trading him for a Lamb, maybe a couple draft picks, and again, not too much. It didn't work out too well for them. Aaron Afalo, undervalued talent in Orlando. L.A. kid, maybe he can end up in L.A. He would be a nice fit. Kobe wants to be a point guard when he gets to the later part of his career, end part of his career, so Afalo could fit well as a 2 guard with him there. DeMar DeRozan has just outplayed himself crazily this year, and I'm just loving all about it. And Jimmy Butler to round it out. That's a Jimmy Butler, baby. He's just a man among men. And you know what? He could very well be number 2 on that shooting guard list come next year. This guy brings it both ends. He can shoot. He's getting his offensive game together. He just has not been healthy this year as much. And it's evident to his consistency and play with that. So it's hard to get a rhythm, you know. You can be out there, you know, and everything like that. But if you don't have your rhythm, it's a different story. Point guards, most important position on the court. CP3, you know, that he just he sets the tone. I mean, great defensively, best defensive point guard, and best offensive point guard. So you really can't go wrong with that. Rajon Rondo, I'm going to give it to him, even though he's playing with a bad Boston team. You put him around some superstars. You put him around Kevin Durant. This kid makes just anything happen. So Damian Lillard, I'm going to put it in my number three. He's just supplanted himself. He's going to grow. He's only, he's wet behind the ears here still in the league, but he's still making a name for himself. So that's something to be seen with. And I always liked him since Portland drafted him. Same with C.J. McCollum. So they got a good problem there at having some good point guards there in Portland. Steph Curry, got to give it to him. He's tearing it up in Golden State. Just tearing it up. They need to get him a good backup point guard, though, so that they don't put too many miles on him. As you know, his ankles are Doritos, so you don't want to break those things. And then Ty Lawson and Tony Parker. Tony Parker, of course, always be on the list. And Ty Lawson has just brought his game to just a great level, playing with, just an under-average team in Denver, but he's just been so consistent and put on a better team, he'd be very dangerous. So New Yorkers very upset that he is gone. So well, I'm Jay Smalls, thanks for joining me. I just wanted to go over the top five of every position here in the NBA currently as we sit here in mid-March here going into March Madness. So Chintade, I got a little tune here to take us out. And you guys have a good one. Send your likes, comments, and thanks. You guys have a good one. Cerebral Sports Chicago. Just Google us up. You'll find us.
Yeah, what up, Detroit?
I'll bring you everything.
No, he didn't. They didn't do it again. What? Why you shit on these niggas
again?
Oh, for sure.
No. This is special right here.
What?
Talk to the boogie, baby. Boogie. Yeah, what's cracking, right?
Just let me lay back and kick some old simplistic pimp shit on slim shit. Start rise like Limp Bizkit. Stone guilty conscience at concerts and watch mosh pits. Some motherfuckers knock each other unconscious. Some of these crowds that slim draws as rowdy as Crenshaw Boulevard when it's packed and full of cars. Some of these crowds me and Snoop draw is niggas from Crenshaw, from Long Beach to South Central. Not these niggas again, these grown ass ignorant men with hand triggers again. You and what army can harm me? D.R.E. and Shady with Doggy from Long Beach. Came a long way to making these songs play. It'll be a wrong move to stand me the wrong way. I got a long ooze and I carry it all day. Sometimes it's like a nightmare that's being Andre. But I
somehow, some way. Hello, nigga. You know about bell games. Now let me cut these niggas up and show them where the fuck I'm coming from. I kick the party crackin'.